Hi friends, in this video let us discuss the substitution theorem. Substitution theorem states that any branch can be substituted if we know the voltage across the branch and the current passing through the branch. That means we can substitute any branch with any combination of any element without changing the voltage across that and current passing through the same branch. Let us see with a simple example. If this is a resistance and this is a voltage source, and now this is one more resistor here. If the voltage source is having 24 volt and the resistance is having 3 ohm and this resistance is having 3 ohm, for example. So the current passing through this, actually I want to substitute the part, the X and Y, this branch I like to substitute with some other elements. Let us see how can we do this. So first I need to identify the current passing through this 5 ohm resistor, I mean current passing through this branch. So current I is equal to voltage is 24 divided by sum of the resistances 3 plus 5 ohm, which is equal to 24/8 is equal to 3 ampere. So in this branch 3 ampere of current is flowing. So this is the current in this branch. Now I like to find what is the voltage in this branch. Obviously the voltage should be, according to Ohm's law, 5 ohm into 3 ampere, that should be 15 volt is flowing in this branch. So now I can conclude that this is a branch having 3 ampere of current flowing through it and it is having 15 volt of voltage across it. So I can simply substitute this part. So I can remove this part. So easily I can remove this part, which implies this is substitution, so I need to substitute this into some other element. See, if this is X and Y, this element is 5 ohm, current passing through is 3 ampere and with 15 volt, like this. I can simply replace this with a 15 volt battery, allowing 3 ampere to pass through it with 15 volt battery, or I can simply have 3 ampere current passing through it, maintaining 15 volt here, or I can simply have one resistance in series with the voltage. Now this is our duty, so the current has to be 3 ampere. And the final voltage, capital X and capital Y, the final voltage should be 15 volt. So there are so many combinations here, we can play whatever we like. Our job is to make it 15 volt. So if this is 1 ohm, for example, the voltage here should be 3 volt. So obviously the battery should be of 12 volt to compensate this. I mean, to make the total voltage 15 volt, so 12 volt battery has to be replaced. Otherwise, see, if this resistance value is 2 ohm, so obviously 6 volt is dropped here, so this should be 15 minus 6, how much? It should be 9 volt. So I need to place a 9 volt battery here. Okay, this is the thing. So we need, in every time we need to see that the current passing through the branch should be same, that means 3 ampere, and the voltage across the branch should be 15 volt. Similarly, the same thing can be given with a current source in parallel with the resistance where X and Y are there. So obviously the voltage should be 15 volt and the current is 3 ampere here. So let me take 1.5 ampere here. So 1.5 ampere is flowing through this So how much is the resistance? It should be 15 volt. So resistance into 1.5 is equal to 15. So obviously the resistance should be 15 divided by 1.5. It should be 0.1 ohm. Okay, is it correct or not? No, the it should be 10 ohm as they should, which is 15 divided by 15 into 0.1. So 0.1 will go up, so it will be 10 ohm, sorry. So this is the thing. So I can replace the same thing. If the resistance is 10 ohm, so 3 ampere is by using current source, I am providing 1.5 ampere by using, so obviously the remaining current is 1.5 here. So 1.5 into 10 ohm will be equal to 15 volt. So this is the substitution for this branch. So this branch can be substituted into so many ways. This may be the one of the ways, maybe other way, this is other way, this is other way, and there are some other combinations also. Even I can use other combinations also here. I may use 1 ampere, I may use 3 ampere also, I may use 2 ampere. Okay, these are the other combinations for me. So this is the substitution theorem. That means, okay, I am simply recap the same theorem. The any branch of any network can be replaced with any number of elements and any combination of elements without changing the voltage across the element and current passing through the element. In this example, the current passing through the element is 3 ampere and voltage across the element is 15 volt. So this element and current and voltage, all these things are substituted successfully without changing the voltage across the branch and current passing through the branch. Voltage across the branch and current passing through the branch, and same thing. So this is the complete explanation of substitution theorem. If you have any doubts in substitution theorem, please write in the comment box. If you like this video, please like it. If you want to share this video with your friends and family or colleagues, please share this. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel and please press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload any new video. Thank you. Thank you very much.